plumberry in.
Not bad.
Yeah.
And so, skål.
Og velkommen til Cimbrer.
Cimbrer camp, my friend.
Product placement.
No bushcrafters were hurt or injured during the collection of these berries.
Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. And today you can see I'm in my camp and I got my son with me. Yeah, my son from Aarhus is working down there and he's on a little vacation here in Aalborg where I live. And I actually persuade him to take with me out here in the camp. And his name is Casper, and as you can see, we are much alike. And my father, his grandfather, looked exactly like us, balded and with beard. So that's a family tradition, if you can say it that way. As you saw, I was out collecting some blackberries, and it's a little bit early in the season because most of the berries are red yet. So in a couple of weeks I can harvest more, but today I harvested this, and it's about 300 grams. And I would like to make some marmalade from this blackberries. So that's the purpose with this video today. Besides having my son with me, it's the first time he's out here. It's very busy down in Aarhus, so I think it's a great time to have him out here in my camp. So now we're going to start a fire, and it's been raining a little bit, so I actually planned it to make a fire in my fire pit, and I hope I can do that. Still, at least I will try, but if it is beginning to rain heavily, I have to come in here and I shelter. So, hope you like, hope you enjoy.
Doesn't that look nice? But before I can begin to make marmalade out of this, I have to clean them and rinse them in some water, and then cook them in a little pot I got with me. So, yeah. But it looks delicious.
And now it's cooked for a little bit more than half an hour, and I think it's finished.
So I'll take it off, put it over here, and then to make it special, Cimbrer Camp Blackberry Marmelade, of course I'll add some whiskey and hope that will make it taste even better. And then it has to cool off. But now, yeah, now it's time for my coffee, our coffee. Today we're gonna make a large portion because we are two here. And the last one. Yeah. But mustn't forget the salt. Yeah, and look at this. Once again, I have received some nice gifts from a wonderful subscriber. This time it's a guy called Markus from Germany, and he sent me these two things. And this is actually honey. It's called Løvensahn honey in Germany. In Denmark, we also call this lion tooth. It's a dandelion, and this is honey from that plant. I never tasted that before, so I'm looking very much forward to that. It's very liquid, so it's a thin honey, and I think it is also good when you're cooking food. So, and then this one, look at this. He has carved it himself, and this symbol is called Valknut. And it is without any doubt the most popular Viking symbol. It is also known as Odin's knot, the knot of the slain warrior. This symbol is considered to be the symbol of Odin. And the word Valknut is derived from two different words. Valna means slain warrior and Knut means knot. This is so cool, and of course this is going to be hanged up in my Cimbrer camp next to all my other Viking symbols. Thank you so much, Markus, for your generosity, your kindness and support. I really appreciate these two gifts from you. Yeah.
Ripping.
Like in Norway? Could you cool it off a bit?
It's very hot.
Yeah, I know.
That's what I was going to do. It's good too.
Maybe it's hot now.
Nice coffee. I discovered if it's a little bit thin, more whiskey added makes it taste better. So
it's so clear we can almost see the bottom of the cup now.
Almost, yeah. There's a Danish saying, we drink a lot of coffee here in Denmark, and in the old days they come schnapps in, and they said, black coffee, a coin down in the bottom, and then pour schnapps in until you could see the coin. So that's an old Danish saying. Perhaps I should try that one day with my whiskey. Well, it has to be an overnight because I can't drive home then.
Houston, we have a problem.
Oh, yeah.
But it certainly cools it off.
Yeah. That's too. Now it's cool a little bit, so I'll put it down here in this jar and come it in the refrigerator. Then I hope it will be a little more creamy. But it looks delicious, I must say. Yips. Looking forward to taste this. Well, this is all for now, folks. Thank you for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft and coming out here in my camp together with my son Casper and me, and enjoy the day. It's not going to be a long video. The weekend here I have plans, so I can't record there. So this is a video I'm making in the middle of the week, just a short one, but I hope you enjoy it as well. Well, thank you for coming, Casper. I really appreciate that. It's been a wonderful day out here, and I hope the marmalade will taste good when it's been cold in the fridge, and perhaps I'll take a picture of it so you can see how it turned out. So, thank you again for watching. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye. Take care.
Yeah, thanks for a lovely afternoon in the camp at this thing called life. And I would love to ask you, do you always put coffee in your whiskey?
Always coffee in my whiskey, yeah, that's right. And even whiskey in my marmalade, as you saw. So.
Looking forward to
that. Yeah. See you all, folks.